Katikira jubileo Wabadja wabazi mungesa Engambo Muna masomero kawanango Kabaka ya mukunganya Yeyala gidemba karanga muntomu Kofitu kole kwa yemu Amasomero bonda
Mbuto eses data watu gambi Tuyimbeneva na fabalala Kwe mwoyo bobu tukasego katesio
Tukasesa longo Obukata mbuchedete
Tuyimbire bene kujubileo
Adati simanyo ne mama
part of that Choli culture. I'm now taking you guys into what we call a move of organizing the food that is in that traditional marriage. And I would like to say that I'm taking you to where these guys are actually slaughtering the animal that is going to be given to in-laws that is in the traditional marriage. Yes, just as you see the screen of your television, the team is just right here doing an amazing job. And I would like you to have a full glimpse of what is happening around this place. Yes, what is happening around this place. I would like you to look at this is a cow. Yes, if you look at it critically from the head, this is a cow. And for most guys who come from the central part of the country, these are intestines. I know very many families that cannot afford to eat meat, eat what they call bienda. Yes, this is a bienda, and that is the process that it takes to organize bienda. They first soak it somewhere, and after soaking it, it is washed to clean all the types of the intestines that are there, Obama, Sam, and those other related types, before they are organized to be put on a saucepan. So most of you who don't know how this cultural food is organized, this is how it's organized in northern Uganda. And by the way, be reminded that it's cooked together with the meat, because it's believed that it's what gives the meat the taste. Yes. Now this head also is roasted. Actually, it's first of all, it's sort of smoked. Yes, it's smoked. After being smoked, they will remove the foreskin. Then it will be heat, and after being heated, it will be converted into meat. So the skin from all over the head will be converted into meat. Now the men are the ones who are responsible with this work. Just as you look at the screen of your television, the men are the ones that are responsible for the slaughtering of the bull. In the slaughtering area, women are not allowed to step there. They even cut it into the pieces they want, and at the end of the day, when they're done with everything, it is handed over to the women to now execute the cooking part of it, where men are not involved. So that is what happens in the traditional setup. You see the liver down there? Yes, that is where the Muko eats and his team. Yes, the liver down there. You can look at some bit of Molokony. For most of you who don't know Molokony, this is how Molokony looks like. Yes, I would love you to have a real look at what Molokony is when it's off the cow. This is the look at how the Molokony you always find in the saucepan. This is how it looks like. Yes, this is the Molokony of a cow, and they've just cut it out of the cow. This one is going to be cleaned with warm water. After that, it's going to be cut into pieces. And after cutting it into pieces, it's going to be boiled. When they're boiling it, they always put simple things like onions, tomatoes, but they don't fry it. They do it boil. So this is the look of what we call the Molokony. Yes, this is Molokony. At the same time, I would like to show you the major tools that I use. They use the knives, they use the axe, and on the side of the axe, they always have a strong piece of wood by the side that will help them cut the heaviest bones. Now, I want to take you the sideways of the cutting parlor, the sideways from where they're cutting this meat from. I'm gonna go get some. Africa, this is what happens. In the process of the roasting, okay, not only the process of roasting, in the process of the slaughtering of the bull or the cow that is going to be given to the in-laws of the home, what happens is very many things happen around, and one of the things is they always do roasting of the first parts. So actually, in the Acholi culture, the men test the cultural setup of food before it goes to the kitchen. Now, this fire that you're looking at by my side, being lit by this young man, is actually a fire that is being set to organize the roasting of the first things. For example, they can cut a piece of the kidney, they can cut out a piece of some meat, they can cut out a piece of the pancreas, and they bring and put it here. Now, those are the things they first roast before the whole thing is being put on the big saucepans. Now, that one, they always put salt, and by the side, they'll be taking that local waraji that I would love to show you. Yes. I would also love to actually, for the first time, explore the local cultural drink. Yes. See where I'm picking it from? According to the Acholi culture, they don't just expose it, they know where to place it. See where I'm picking it from? Don't ask me how I smoked out to get to know that it was here. And don't say that I am also a member. You never know. Okay, all right. So this is actually the Acholi cultural drink. I don't know, what is it called in the local language? Arege. This is a cultural drink called Arege. Arege. It's called Arege. And I would like to have a taste of it.
You take it back.
Let me add little and
you are going to earn more.
Hey, you add more than one bottle.
Oh.
You are cold bottle,
Arege. This is how it tastes. If I'm to explain it for you. It is also called Lumugu, just as you hear. The nickname is Lumugu in the land. It's one of the drinks they take. And it's a cultural drink made out of the local plants. Things like cassava, dried cassava, fermented, and they come out with it. So that is exactly what happens in the pala where they slaughter this cultural food, this cultural meat to be given to the in-laws. I hope you've been seeing around. Even the other side, there are other types of birds like chicken and so forth, just like that. Yes, that is about the Acholi culture.